hardy perennials and a lot of plant material that goes into the pots around the clubhouse. So over here we have the Phormiums in the back, New Zealand flax. So those are, you'll see those on the pots at number 10 or up in the bag drop, big exposed aggregate pots. Same with these cedars over here. They go in the big pots. And then a lot of the stuff in the center is the rosemary and the lime cypress that I used in the 36 pots that went out on the course last year. And then you will have seen a lot of this plant material, as I say, dotted around the course or up at the clubhouse or at the concession. And we're in the greenhouse. So over here are all of the hypertufa. Karen and I are always arguing over what the real term is. So these are all the succulent pots that go up at the patio at the clubhouse. And then I start what I can from them, and I start tons. Ivies that I've grown on from the mother plants that would be used in the 36 pots or pots around the place. This is the big hibiscus that goes at the front door to the concession. So perhaps the next segment you'll see it all pruned down. More hypertufa, some leftover poinsettias from Christmas that if they cooperate, we can make them bigger. This is that big fern that goes at the front door in the urn. Here's some bougainvilleas that I've smuggled in cuttings. They go away and I come back with things. Here's what you can do with grapefruit seeds. Make your own grapefruit tree. I think this is an orange or a lime. If you want to check if you really want to know what they are, you break the leaf and you can usually smell it. I think it's lemon. Yeah? And it's bearing fruit, so Char can have another gin and tonic. It's a key lime. And again, more storage of plant material that goes out on the course. And things that have come in for rehab. And here's the center bench. So in a normal year, it would be covered with seed trays. So I start a lot of the petunias. Mm-hmm. A lot of the annuals get started in here. And then, oh yes, the staghorn ferns. So go back and you can see the big, big one. There's some people that think that it looks like a big monster, but these get hung up on the pillars up at the patio. And then these are cuttings off of one of the other ones, cuttings pups. So they can all get. Just cool. Mm-hmm. And when I'm not gardening, I can bake. Talansias, the air plants. So if you keep them long enough, they just multiply. And there's another type of air plant. Another pet, Phalaenopsis that I mounted. With a Talansia stuck in there, some Dendrobiums. The ladies that were here for the wreath building did get to see this ugly looking orchid bloom. It only seems to bloom in the winter. So these are some of the orchids that are left over from the big freeze. About 6 or 7 years ago, the greenhouse froze, so I lost a lot of plant material. Actually, this is what's left of this tree froze, and I was able to cut it down and promote new growth on that one. And then over here, more plants that'll go out onto the out up at the summer